I did a special appearance at Mama's Mall. A young lady came to me, and I gave her the name of a man, and that was her husband. I told her I saw her with another man, and I gave a name, and she said it sounded crazy, and she went to the front desk at the fair and complained that I was saying crazy things. And a couple of years later, I did a special appearance again, and the lady sat down with me and said that the name, second name I gave her, was now her husband, her new husband. So you never know what you're going to come up with. But I met an Egyptologist, and he showed me some charts that they found in a pyramid that people really didn't understand. And from all my studying of numbers, both with the Cairo, who was Count Lewis Harmon, and his system of emphatic numbers, and the books that Thelma Van Wert loaned me to teach classes, and the lessons that Miles Danka taught me in a mall about tarot cards and numbers and the occult. Occult actually means hidden or mysterious meanings. It's not about devils and goblins. It's really means something which is hidden or difficult to understand. And is there something that we're not supposed to know? In these charts that were found in pyramids, it would show somebody's name, and it would show their name put into a pyramid, an upside down pyramid. And this would predict every major change in their life. It took me a couple of years of futzing with it to really find out exactly how it worked. But as soon as I saw the charts that the Egyptologist showed me, I knew exactly what it was. But at that point, I had so much number, numerology, Kabbalah, and esoteric experience that I immediately knew what it was, and I went out to uncover the truth behind it. I had met a lady called Kylie who had written a book on acrophonology, which is name analysis. And I sat down and had a session with her, and I also bought her book, and I learned her methods, and then I added my own. In all these things, after a while, a master of these things starts developing their own methods, and they streamline things. The old astrologers would take a couple of hours to make out a chart and a couple of more hours to do interpretation. That's well and good for a couple of choice clients. But if you want to do a group of people, or you want to give somebody some fast, valuable knowledge, the abracadabra and regular numerology and a little cards would go a long way to give a lot of information without all this tedious work involved. Even Dusty Bunker and Rhoda Nordic, who wrote the Divine Triangle, their system would take hours in order of numbers and putting them in series in order to make up a basic chart. And an astrology reading is very similar with the ephemeris. It's a long, protracted system. And I wanted to develop a method and a system of coming right down to the facts right away without going through this long, tedious calculations and charts, so that you can give kind of a mini session and somebody would walk away with a whole lot of information. Now, most psychics are like a poor man's psychic. The person asks a question. The questions really have an answer built into them. If they say, will my husband ever stop drinking? Well, you know, he's a drunk. And now you could describe every drunk, how he's unsteady and he has bad periods and he spends a lot of money and he disappears. And they'll say, oh, you know, just exactly like him. But no, you actually described every drunk in the world. So, I mean, that's the art of cold reading. And a real psychic reading, you're giving them real information. You're not just working with the person's information. When they ask a question, you're working with their information. When you make predictions, you're working with your information and your perceptions. So there's a big difference between questions and answers and somebody actually making real predictions. I used to teach groups of real professional psychics how to make real predictions in the real world. Most of them really didn't know how to make predictions. All they did was get in a conversation with people and back and forth questions and answers and probing and so forth and so on. I always said that they were more of a poor man's psychiatrist than a psychic. But anyway, those are the words of Alan. And if you see Alan V on YouTube, I did magic shows. I used to donate my time to muscular dystrophy, senior places, medical daycare centers, hospital fundraisers. And when I was a psychic, very often I worked the whole week. Muscular dystrophy, fundraisers, didn't make a dime. I would take off from my regular job, use my vacation time. And those are the words of Alan V.